Hello and welcome, students. So in this course, we are going to take a look at a couple of points. For example, we are going to learn about database attack techniques for databases, right? How you can attack on a database and how you can gather information from database, like for example, email IDs, usernames, passwords, all sensitive data which is available in the backend. And we are going to use basically attack tools of Kali Linux OS here. So inside Kali Linux, we have tools available for database attacks, and I'm going to show you some of them which are really popular and really useful, right? So we will use a sample website here, and on that sample website we are going to attack, right? So this is the scenario. We have an attacker and we have a database, and database is inside, obviously, inside web server. So web server contains database, right? So if you want to attack on a website, right, so you are at the front end of the website and you need to enter some queries so that you can connect with the back end of the database, right, which is back end of the server, or you can say database. So these queries are called SQL queries. SQL is called structured query language, and this language is used to communicate from front end to the back end. So if I have a website, so I have the front end, but I don't have the back end, right? So if I want to communicate with the back end of the website, so I need to send some SQL queries to the back end. And if I ask a question to the back end in the form of SQL queries, then it will give me an answer, right? So that's what database attack. I want to send some malicious content to the database, and if database is not aware that this is a malicious content, it will send me the information what I want as an attacker, right? What I want as an attacker: all content of database, everything stored in the database, mobile numbers, fax numbers, email IDs, addresses, customer name, customer email ID, everything I need from the database. So that we are going to do in this section. Now, if I talk about the database structure, so we are talking about the backend or database, but if you don't know the database structure, then you are not able to attack. So we need to understand what is the structure of a database, general structure of a database, right? So the general structure of a database, you can see this is called a database, right? This complete shell is called database, right? Inside database, we have tables. So inside every table, for example, if database has four tables, so you will see basically four tables inside the database. So for example, this is a database, right? So it will contain actually four tables like this, right? So these are called tables. Tables are inside database. This is a shell for tables. Inside tables, we have columns. So inside each and every table, we have columns. For example, if student is a table name, then in student, I can have the student name, student roll number, right? So this is called columns, and columns are inside tables. So this shell is called columns. Outer shell of columns is called table, and outer shell of table is called database. The most inner shell of the database is called data, and this is need. Basically, if attacker tries to attack on the database, actually it needs the data, right? So to gather data, you need to go step by step inside that database. First of all, find out information about database name, then gather information about the table names, then gather information about the column names, and then you can find out the data inside that, right? So this is a kind of database structure we are going to use in the videos. Now, if you talk about the introduction of database attack, then the database attack is related to gather information, which is a sensitive information from database. Like I already told you that it can be a username of any login page, it can be password, emails, addresses can be gathered. So these kind of information can be gathered from the database, and that is called database attack actually. So database assessment or attack tools are already available in Kali Linux. So inside Kali Linux OS, we already have a database assessment section, right? If when you will click on applications in Kali Linux, you will see a new chapter inside database assessment, and it contains so many tools, 10 to 15 tools are available there, but we are going to learn the most important tools among them, right? For example, SQL map is available here. So SQL, you can use SQL map for database assessment, right? JSQL is available there. You can also use it, and you can also try to attack on the website without using any tool. We are also going to merge it inside this section. So this is all about this section, and from the next video we are going to start the practical part of database attack techniques. So this is all about the theory part of database attacks, right? Hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for your time, and we will come back in the next video. Hello and welcome, students, to the practical part of website hacking or SQL injection. So in this video, I'm going to show you that how you can attack on a website using Kali Linux operating system. So we are going to perform a structured query language to attack on the web applications and websites. So how we can attack on a website? Let's talk about this. So first of all, the tool which we can use to attack on the website is SQL map. So if you click on applications, right, and if you click on database assessment, then you will find this tool, SQL map. The work of SQL map is to attack on a website and gather the information from the database of the website, right? Or you can say gather information from the backend. That is the work of SQL map. So how we can attack on a website? Let me show you. So click on first of all SQL map. It is a command line tool, right? So first of all, let me show you what is SQL map. So you can type on terminal man space SQL map and hit enter. So it will show you the information about the manual entry inside the Kali Linux operating system. So SQL map is an automatic SQL injection tool, as you can see on the screen, right? And basically these are the synopsis and the options are available here. So if you want to attack on a website and if you want to use SQL injection as a method, then SQL map is the best tool available in Kali Linux operating system, right? So how we can use it? Let me show you. So first of all, open your browser, Firefox, and first of all, let's take a website. For example, we will actually work on the sample website. We will not attack on any live website. So it will be illegal if you try on somebody else's website, right? So just you can try on your website. Otherwise, you can try on sample website. So the sample website I'm taking is vulnweb.com, because this is a sample website provided by Acunetics tool. So this is vulnweb.com, and if you open this, this is the link of the website. Open that, and here you can see on the screen, let me zoom it. So there you can see on the screen there are four links available, right? As we are working on MySQL, right? So I will choose the second one, which is testphp.vulnweb.com. So click on that and open this website. So this is the website you can see on the screen, right? testphp.vulnweb.com, and we will try to find out information about this website. We will try to find out information about the username and password so that we can put here and get information about their database, etc., right? So how we can attack on this website? First of all, to attack via SQL injection, you need to find the link of the website. That is really important to start. So how you can get the link? Just copy the URL area here, right? Open a new link, open a new tab actually. And here you can simply type here site colon, paste the web URL here, space PHP question mark ID equals to. Right, it will help you to find the links available for the website. Hit enter, and you can see here that these kind of links we need to attack on the website. testphp.vulnweb.com/artist.php question mark artist equal to 1. So let's take this link, copy that, right, and minimize everything. Now do one thing, just open your terminal of Kali Linux operating system. Let me zoom it for you. Yeah. So first of all, as we already know that the outer shell of any web application backend is database. So we need to find a database first of all. Then later we will find out the table name, then column name, and then the data, actual data, which is inside the database. So my aim is here, first of all, to find out the name of the databases and number of the databases so that we can move further. So how we can get the database name here? Let me show you. So there are some fixed commands available in SQL map tool that we can use. So what you can do, you can simply type SQL map space dash small u and paste here the link which you have copied from here, and you can minimize this. All right, testphp.vulnerweb.com/artist.php?artist=1 SQL map dash u, after that type the link of the website and space what you want to find. I want to find a database, so you can type DBS. DBS means databases. Test dash DBS to find the databases of this website and hit enter. So you can see here that SQL map has started, and it is asking a question that it looks like the backend is MySQL. Do you want to skip test payloads specific for DBMSs? If yeah, so what you will type here, yes or no. It is saying that we have found the databases regarding MySQL. Do you want to skip? Yes, we want to skip because we have already found the database name. So you can type Y and hit enter. It is saying that for the remaining tests, do you want to include all tests for MySQL? Yes, I want to test, and type Y and hit enter. Now it will test the web application or the web link which we have provided, and then it will find out information about the databases in the backend. So you need to just wait, right? You can see here that it is trying, it is attacking on MySQL, right? Regarding parameter replace or procedure analysis, right? Stack queries. And it is basically attacking on the artist. It is saying that parameter artist appears to be MySQL 5.0.12 and time-based blind injectable. All right. So it is taking some time, and you can see here that it is trying on 20 columns and trying to find the number of columns available in the application. So you need to wait, and it will find out a single parameter which will be vulnerable, and we need to use that parameter to attack on the website, right? And then we will able to find the basically first the username and password, right? And we will be able to change the database information, right, by using SQL injection. So you need to just wait. So now you can see on the screen that we got the two databases here, and the first database is accurate and second database is information_schema. So basically information_schema is a kind of default database, right? And we will use accurate database, right, to find the number of tables. So you can see here that we got the number of databases available here, right? If it just remember one thing, if you get stuck here, right, then please hit enter and it will start it again. All right. So now we are going to use accurate database here to find out information, accurate database. And now we will try to find the number of tables inside accurate database. So how you can do that? You can simply type SQL map space dash u. You need to paste the link space. Now you need to specify the database name. So database name is accurate. So you can type here dash capital D, and the name of the database is accurate space. What you need to find, we are finding the number of tables. So you can type here dash dash tables, right, and hit enter, and you will get the tables inside accurate database. Hit enter, and you can see that it is retrieving the table names. So here you can see that data inside database accurate, there are 8 tables, and inside 8 tables, these are the name of the tables: artist, cards, category, users, products, etc. Right? So inside a single database, there are 8 tables. It looks like, for example, there is a square, right? And you are trying to divide that in 8 parts. So that they are the tables in which we need to find out information about the username and passwords. So I think if I guess, then I think this will be the right table name where I can get information about the usernames, passwords, etc. So the, I will take the user's table name and I will find out the number of columns from this table name. So how we can find the number of columns? To find the number of columns, you can simply type SQL map space dash U and paste here the link space dash capital D. You need to type the database name. So database name is accurate that we already found. Now we need to specify the table name. So that dash capital T table name is, I'm taking users. So you can type here users space. And now we are trying to find the column name. So we can type column dash dash columns. All right. So it will provide you the number of columns and the name of the columns from users table, right? Hit enter. So you can see here that inside database accurate, there is a table name users. Inside table name users, there are 8 columns available, right? And we have found out 8 columns in which you can see there are email IDs and password is also available. Uname is also available, phone number, address, etc. Right. Now next task is to find out information about, first of all, uname. Uname is, I think, username, and pass is, I think, password. I'm just guessing, right? So let's find out information about the uname first of all. So to get username information, you can type SQL map dash u, paste here the link space dash capital D, and you need to specify the name of the database, which is accurate dash capital T. You need to specify the table name. So I think the table name was users, right? Inside users table name, we are trying to find the column. So the column name is uname. You can type dash capital C and uname, right? Space dash dash dump. So finally, you need to type dash dash dump to extract the information about username from these tables, right? Hit enter. So there is only one column. I think it is showing just one here. And it is showing us the username TEST, I think. Yeah, so you can see here that is that it has provided us the username information. Username is test. Similarly, we can find information about the password. So you can type here, just click here and click on your upper arrow of your keyboard, right? And just replace this uname with PASS, because there is another column available there. And the name of other column is PASS. So we are going to find out information about password as well and hit enter. Now it is retrieving the password from the database, right? And I think you can see on the screen that the password is also test. So username is test as well as password is test. You can also get information about other information like email IDs, etc. For example, if you take email, so what you can do, click here, click on up arrow to get the command again, and you can type email here to get information about email. So extracting email IDs, whatever inside that. Slowly, slowly, it is taking one character at a time. You can see here that it is extracting the email ID, whatever, basically it is a sample website, right? So that's why all the information available inside the database is also sample. So you can see here on the screen that it is trying to extract the email IDs. And here it is. So this is a kind of email ID available inside the database. Great. So we got the username, right? This is the password test. And this is the username test available. So what we can do here, just minimize this, open the website. And in that website, you can see on the left hand side, there is a button, sign up button here. So click on that. And on that sign up button, you can see there is a username and password. Can you see here? Yeah, this is the username and password panel, right? So we got the username. The username is test. And the password is also test. You can click on login. And you can see here that you are able to get information about the database here, right? You can see the name, you can see if there is any credit card number, if there is any email ID, if there is any phone number, address. You can also update the information from this database. So to update the database, you can simply remove the name. Let me type my name, right? And let me click on update. Please don't put your original information here. Original information, like, don't put your phone numbers or email ID, address, credit card number, right? So because this is visible to all kind of hackers. So click on update, right? It has been updated. Let me log out. Let me log in again. Let me click on sign up. And if I type here test and test, and if I click on login, then you can see here that my name has been updated in that database. Basically, I have updated their database and I have put my entries inside it. Got my point? So you can basically update their database easily, right? It's quite easy. So you have seen in the SQL map that these are the really easy commands which you can use for website pen testing or to attack on a website using SQL injection, right? And you can also move to this directory to get information about you can see that info table accurate users dump to CSV file /root/sqlmap/output, etc., etc. You can see here that this is .sqlmap. That .sqlmap means it is a hidden file. So let me check where it is. Let me click on places, click on home, right? And where is .sqlmap? .sqlmap output test1web.com, and inside that you can see dump accurate users.csv. So dump accurate users.csv. You can see here that this is the information has been stored inside this file. So all the information has been saved, right? And you can get information here. The logs are also available that what you have done. It will help you to create a report, right, for the client. And this is target.txt. You can see here information about the command. So these information can help you to create a final report for your client, right? So this is all about SQL map, right? And don't try this method on somebody's website, right? You can try this method on your own website or on a sample website like this, right? So thank you so much, and try this again, right? And we will come back in the next video with more interesting videos. Thank you so much. Hello and welcome, students. And in this video, I'm going to show you that how you can attack on a website without using any tool, right? You can use the tools available in Kali Linux to attack on a website. For example, you can use SQL Map, SQL Sys, SQL Ninja. There are so many tools are available in Kali Linux. But can you attack on a website without using any tool? So that's what I'm showing here in this video, that how you can attack on a website using manual SQL injection method. So this method is really simple, right? And there is no use of any tool for manual injection. So let me show you how you can do that. So to do that, you can see that we already have our sample website, which is testphp.vulnerweb.com. And obviously we will try to attack on this website. So first of all, what you need to do here, we need a simple link of this website, right? And to get a link of this website, what we can do here, we can simply click on artists. Here you can see to get a link, I'm showing you that how you can get a link. So click on artists and click on the first link. So you get a link automatically, testphp.vulnerweb.com/artist.php?artist=1, right? So this is the link available here, and I'm going to use that link to attack on this website to get the username and password available in the backend or database. So let's try. First of all, let me copy this. Let me open a new tab, open google.com, and here on Google, what we can do, we can simply type site colon, paste here, or basically you don't need to do that because we already have the link. So do one thing, paste that link here, right? And now we will check that this website is vulnerable to SQL injection or not. So how we can check it? It's quite simple. You can just type an apostrophe after one. You can, right? And hit enter. If it gives us an error message, it means the website is vulnerable to SQL injection attack. So you can see on the screen that we are getting an error message. This is the warning message we are getting, right? This is the warning message from the backend that MySQL fetch array expects parameter 1 to be resourced boolean given in this PHP line on 62. So if this kind of error is coming from the backend by using this apostrophe after that or single code, so it means the website is vulnerable to SQL injection, and we are I'm pretty sure that we can attack on this website using manual SQL injection technique. All right. Now the next task is to find out the number of columns inside the database, because we have no clue that how many numbers are there inside the database, right? Because if you are using any kind of tool like SQL map, right? For example, if you are using SQL map, so they are basically doing it internally. We don't need to do it inside SQL map. But if you are performing manual SQL injection, you need to do everything here. Now we need to find the number of columns, and we don't have any method to find out. There is only one method, and the method is called trial and hit method, or you can say hit and trial method, right? So how we can find it? Do one thing, just remove the apostrophe and type order by, right? There is a method available which is order by using that you can try to find the number of columns in the database. So what you can do here, you can simply type here order space by space. For example, if I try with five, let me guess there are five columns. So let me try with order by five dash dash and hit enter. So you can see here that there is no changes in the page here. So let me try with four. Still on four, there is no change on the page. I'm just looking for a change on the page. Let me try 3, and you can see here that when I have typed 3, when I tried 3, then it has changed the look of the page, right? You can see here, and on the 4 it will give us an error. Here you can see it means there are 3 columns available there. This is a kind of hit and trial method that I'm showing you. So by using order by method, you can find out the number of original columns inside the website. So order by 3 dash dash will provide you the page, order by 4 dash dash will provide you an error message. It means there are 3 columns are available. Great. Let me remove everything. Now the task is to find the table names from the, we don't need to find database here, right? Because we can directly find a table name here and then column names and then the data. So how we can find the table name without using any tool? Do one thing. Let me show you the command. What command you can use? So you can simply type here union select 1, 2, group underscore concat, then table underscore name from information underscore schema dot tables. I will explain you, just type it information underscore schema dot tables, where table schema equals to database bracket close bracket and dash dash. So let me explain you what is this. So we were here at artist equal to one. Now I have typed union space select space 1, 2, and the command. So actually there are 3 columns available here, right? So that's why I'm typing 1, 2, 3, but the third one has been replaced by the command, because we need to use a single column so that we can get enter in the website. So that's why I'm using third column. So if I'm using third column, so I have replaced 3 with this command. So the command is to gather information about the table names. So you can see here group underscore concat table name from information schema dot tables, where table underscore schema equal to database dash dash. This is the command to get the table name from the databases. If I hit enter, you can see here that we didn't get any table names here, Nothing. So what is the problem here? The problem is quite simple, that there are three possibilities here. Let me show you what are the three possibilities. For example, let me show you in the leaf pad what are the three possibilities. So the three possibilities are like, for example, the link is this, right? This is the link. The three possibilities are here is you can try like this, or you can try like dash one, you can try with one dash, and you can try both of them at one play. So there are these three possibilities are available here. Either you use dash one, or you use one dash, or you use dash one dash, because one of them can work for you here. So let me try this. Let me minimize this, and you can see here that this is the link available here, and I need to use, for example, if I use with one dash and hit enter. So you can see here there is no change. I'm not getting any table names here. Let me try with both of them, dash and dash one dash, hit enter. Still there is no changes. The last option is to remove the apostrophe and just use a dash one, hit enter. And here we go. You can see here that we are getting the number of tables here, which you can see on the screen, right? So you can see here that we got the table names here, and the table names are artist, cards, category, featured, guestbook, pictures, users, and products. That basically you can also try with SQL map. You will get the same number of columns, tables basically. So these are the tables available. So we got the table names here. Now you can use any table. For example, if you want to use users table name, then you can try with users. So if you want to find the column names from this table name, let's find out. So how you can find out the column name? Simply you need to change tables with columns. So if it is table underscore name, so you can type here column underscore name. So you can type here column underscore name. From information underscore schema dot columns, replace tables with columns, columns, where now here you need to change something. So remove this, and now you can type table underscore name equals to, type double quote, inside double quote you need to type the table name. So the table name is users, and after that you can type dash dash, right? So 1, 2, group concat, column name from information underscore schema dot columns, where table underscore name equal to inside double quote users, after double quote type dash dash and hit enter. So you can see here that you got the column names as well, uname, pass, cc, address, email, and we didn't use any tool here, right? We are completely performing a manual technique. We are not using a single tool in this method. So these are all the columns available in the website, uname, pass, address, email, name, phone, etc. So for example, if you want to find a uname here, first of all, we will find the username. So how you can find a username? You need to type, just replace column underscore name with the actual name of the column. So actual name of the column is uname, right? And after that, do one thing. After from, just remove everything. So 1, 2, group underscore concat, uname from the table name. So what is the table name? The table name was users dash dash. This is the command to get the username, hit enter. And you can see here that we got the username here. The name of the username is test. Great. Let me go back. Let's find out information about pass. So to get the pass, just same method, replace column underscore name with pass, right? From the table name. So what is the table name? The table name is users dash dash, right? Hit enter. And you can see here we got the password as well. So the username is test, password is also test. You can try with some other information. For example, if you want to try with address, let me try with address. So just remove column underscore name with address, and just remove everything after from, the name of the table, users dash dash, hit enter. So you can see here this is the address available here. So we got the username, we got the password. Now it's time to log in the website. Click on sign up. right? And here you can simply type the username, which you have got test. Password was also test. And now you can click login. And you can see here that you are inside the database of the website, right? You can change the address if you want. For example, if I change it to New Delhi, click on update. And if I just log out from this website and log in again, type the username test and password is also test, click login. And if you come down, you can see that the address has been changed to New Delhi. So that's how you can get information about the addresses, phone numbers, email IDs, credit card numbers. It's quite easy, right? That we have used a simple commands here, right? And we got the information about. So these are the commands. These are called SQL injection command. So we know how you can use tool to attack on a website using SQL injection. We know how you can use a manual technique without using any tool to gather information about the website, right? So this is a method. This is the most popular method in the world to gather information about the database, to capture information about the username, passwords, to dump the complete database, to wipe out the complete database, to update the complete database using SQL injection, right? So this is all about this manual technique that you can use for any website, right? Try it on this website again, right? So thank you so much. And this is all about the manual SQL injection technique. We will come back in the next video. Hello and welcome students to the next video. And in this video, I'm going to show you in the applications that how you can create your own personal dictionary using crunch command, right? So inside password attacks, you can see there's a command. There's a tool, basically it's a tool, crunch tool, right? And the work of this tool is to create your own personal dictionary, right? So let me show you how you can do that. So if you select password attacks, right, you can click on crunch, and inside crunch there are some options available. Let me show you what are the options available there. So the command for crunch is this: crunch, min, max, and options available. So for example, let me show you one thing. Let me clear everything right now. It's fine. So for example, like my name is Sunil, S-U-N-I-L, and I want to create all the permutation combinations of my name. So how we can do that? We can do this by using crunch command. So let me show you how you can do that. You can simply type crunch space the minimum characters. For example, the minimum character is 1, the maximum character is 5. The pattern means the string. So for example, this is the string, and the way you want to save the file: -o /root/desktop/sunil.txt. So what I'm doing here, I'm creating all the permutation combinations of my name. My name is S-U-N-I-L, right? So you can start with the first name. First, for example, it will take one of them, then it will take two of them, then 3, 4, and then it will end at 5 characters, right? So this is the crunch command. Where you want to save the file, -o for output. Where you want to save the file, you can save this file on desktop with the name of sunil.txt, right? So let me show you. Hit enter. And it is creating 3905, and the command has been completed. It has been executed. Let me minimize that. You can see here on the screen that there is a file which has been created by crunch command. And if I open this file, then you can see on the screen, let me show you one thing. Yeah, here you can see that it has started with a single character. It has taken a single character, then it has taken 2 characters. Then after that, it is taking 3 characters, right? And then after that, it is taking 4 characters. And then later, it is taking 5 characters. So it is taking, actually, this is a dictionary of my name. It is containing all kind of permutation combinations of my name, you can see on the screen, right? So these dictionaries can help you, for example, if you want to try on some kind of password attacks, right? or protocol attacks, etc. So these dictionaries can help you in that. So that's why crunch command is really necessary you to understand. All right, let me close everything. Now let me open the terminal again. This was the command. What if I change it to 3, 5? What will happen if I do this? If you change it to 3, 5, then it will skip the single character. It will skip the two characters. It will start with the three characters. Then it will take 4 characters. Then it will take 5 characters. It means it will skip 1 and 2 characters. Let me show you how. You can hit enter. It is creating 3875. It was 3905 initially. Minimize it and open that file again. So if I come up, you can see here that it has skipped a single character and 2 characters from your dictionary. It is taking 3 characters, and then if you come down, then it is taking 4 characters, and then if you come down, it is taking 5 characters. So there is no place for single and double characters here, right? And you can, if you want, you can skip the 3rd characters. If you want all kind of 5 characters only, that you want to skip single, double, triple and 4 characters, so you can hit enter. So there will be only 5 characters inside that. Let me open this file again. So you can see here that it only contains only 5 characters. It is starting with the 5. There is no place for single, double, triple or 4 characters. Right? So that's how you can use crunch command to create kind of dictionary. So crunch is the command. 5 is the minimum character. 5 is the maximum character. Sunil is the pattern. Dash O is means for output, where you want to save the file. I want to save this file on my desktop with the name of sunil.txt. So you can see here, this is the name of the file, sunil.txt, and it has been saved on the desktop with the name of sunil.txt. Great. Now let me show you one more thing. Let me clear everything. Yeah. Now, for example, if you want to insert some kind of special characters inside it, so how you can do that? Let me show you with my name. So for example, the password is sunil@$ is the password. And if you want to create a dictionary of this, so is it possible or not? Let's try. So let me type crunch space 57 sunil@$ space dash small o, where you want to save the file, /root/desktop/ sunil1.txt. All right, so what I'm doing here, I'm taking 7 characters here, and inside that one of, basically 2 of them are special characters, $@ and $. So I'm starting with 5 characters, and it will go with 6 and then end with 7 characters. So if you want to run this, let's run this file. It is, you can see there that it is making a lot of lines here, right? So if I open this file, so you can see here that all these files are available here. All this information is available here. And you can see here that all the special characters have been merged inside these lines. So you don't need to worry about special characters. You can also create a dictionary with special characters as well. Right? So that's how you can create the dictionary with special characters. And if you want to create a dictionary with numbers, you can also do that. Let me click on the upper arrow and let me change it to 12 and hit enter. Same number of lines, 957,999. Minimize that. Open the sunil1.txt file. And you can see here that you can also merge the numeric values with the characters. Right? Let me close. Let me open this. If you want, you can also merge special characters with numeric values. For example, if I change it to 1, or for example, sunil2@$. So this is the file. Hit enter. Minimize it. Open sunil1.txt. And here you can see that numeric values and special characters have been inserted inside that. Right? You can see here. So you can create any kind of dictionary. You can create basically a dictionary, a personal dictionary. You can create a dictionary with alphanumeric values. You can create a dictionary with simple characters. any kind of character you can insert in the dictionary by using crunch command, right? So that's why crunch command is really necessary you to understand, because if you want to create your own dictionary, then this crunch tool can help you to do that, right? So this is all about the crunch command. I hope you liked it, and we will come back in the next video with more interesting videos. Thank you. Hello and welcome, students. And in this video, I'm going to tell you about the graphical user interface version for SQL injection, right? So SQL injection is basically kind of attack in which you try to insert queries in the database, right? And then database responds with the data inside it. So we have so many tools inside Kali Linux operating system for performing SQL injection on command line, but we have very less tools available which have graphical user interface and for SQL injection, right? So that's why I'm telling you a tool inside Kali Linux which has GUI and where we can work on SQL injection. So just click on applications, select database assessment, and you can click on JSQL injection, right? So click here and wait. So you can see on the screen that this is called JSQL injection, right? And this is a graphical user interface tool, right? Where you can type the complete address here. Here you can see that there is a block available where you can type the end address here, and then you can click here, right? Click on this arrow to start the process. First of all, it will find out information about like database, right? And then it will provide information about tables and then columns and then the data. So we will start with the address here. So first of all, we need to find out the address of a website. Address means a kind of page link. We will paste here and then we will click on this arrow button to start the process. So to do that, I need to open the Firefox in Kali Linux. So let's open Firefox. So I'm clicking on Firefox. Right. And open the website, which is we generally use for testing, vulnerweb.com. And here you can use the second one, testphp.vulnerweb.com. So click here, right? And to find out the link, what you can do, you can click on page inside this website. For example, if I click on artists, so click on that. And you can see that there are three links available. So you can click on any one. For example, if I click on the first one, so you can see I got a link in the URL area, which is testphp.vulnerweb.com/artist.php, which is a page, and *artist=1, which is a link inside that page. So we got a link of the website, and we can use this link inside JSQL to perform SQL injection, right? So what you need to do, you just need to copy this link, right, and paste in the GUI version of JSQL. So let me copy this link, copy that, and paste it right here. So Control V, you can paste here http://testphp.vulnerweb.com/artist.php?artist=1. Great. Now the next task is to, first of all, we need to check that JSQL takes this kind of string or not. So to check that, you can click on this arrow button right on the side, click here and wait. It will start processing. If it doesn't start, then it will give you an error message. If it starts, then it will find out information for you. There are all information available here: files, web shell, SQL shell, upload. You can also perform brute force attack on here, right? Basically, it is taking some time. We need to wait. Our internet is working properly, I think. So I think it should work. Let me close. And you just need to wait if it works or not. You can see here that it is trying hard to find out information, right? You can see it is taking it is using command one by one to find out information about the columns, right? And it is, you can see here that it is trying to insert information. So you can see here that it has basically stopped working, means it has not basically find out information for us. So let me do one thing. Let me type a null character here and let's try again if it works or not with the null character. So you can see here it is trying with the null character. Until it gets the right one, it will not show us anything, right? So that's why, yeah, here we go, we got it. So you can see here, do one thing, just put a dash before one, right? And it will find out information for you. So you can see here that I got the database name. The database name is accurate, that's right. Click on that, right? And you can see here, these all are the table available inside it. So you can see here that it contains 8 tables, right? And in which you can see this is the artist table. If you click on that, it will find out the columns inside it, right? And if you click on that, then you will find out information regarding this table, right? And you can see there is also a users table available. So if you click on users table, then you will find information about the users. You can see here that all information is available right here. Right? So the problem was that it wasn't able to find out the right appropriate method here. That's why I have put dash here. Otherwise, you know, it can take much time if I don't put dash here. Otherwise, it will, first of all, it will use the normal one with the all kind of strings it has. Then it can work with one dash. Then it will work with dash one. So it can take much time. So just reduce the timing. I just put dash one, right? Because there are three possibilities here. One using dash. Second using one dash. One basically it's one apostrophe after one. And third is, let me type what is the three methods. One is dash one, second is dash one apostrophe, and third one is this, right? So there are three methods. So you can use any one to try that if you are able to find it or not, right? So it has found the information for us. So you can see here that you are able to find out information about the files available inside it, the user's file, right? So let me show you how it can work. So for example, if you want to find information about email, right? So tick on email, right click on users, and you can click on load and wait. So you can see here the email inside this website is this sample@email.txt. For example, if you want to try anything else, for example, artist, so click on artists. Or carts, you can tick on price, right click on the carts and click load. So you can find information about the price as well. Close it. Right, actually it is not containing any ROM, that's why it is not showing anything here. Click here, CNAME, features, all the columns inside features, all the columns inside guestbook, inside pictures, right? Inside products, it is available. You can select name, right click on the product, click load. So you can find information about the products, the laser printer, network storage, D-Link, web camera, etc. And if we talk about user table, which is very important, so let me close it. Let me select all kind of information inside users, right? Right click here, click load. So you can see here that all information is available here. You can also select the useful information for you, like username and password. So you can untick all of them and you can just tick pass and uname and right click on the user, click load. And you can see here that you are able to find out the right username and password of this website. Test and test is the right username and password of this website. Information schema also contains, but basically it is the default database inside the database. That's why we are not able to use that. So this is the database name, AccuArt. The tables, these all are the tables inside it, right? Actually, there are 8 tables inside it. Right, and inside 8 tables you need to guess that which table is useful for you. So the table is useful for me is users. I will tick on that. These all are the columns inside this users table name. So I will find out which columns are useful for me. So actually all are the important, but I think uname, pass and email are more important than anyone. So you can right click here, click on load, and you will find those columns right here. You can click on name as well, right click, click on load, and you will find name as well. So you can see that JSQL injection is really easy tool. You are doing nothing. You are just copying and pasting the link inside this, right? And then you are trying to run this command, and then you can find out, basically you can find information about the table names, columns, database very easily. Whatever column data you need, just tick on that column, right click on the table name and click on load, and you will find information right here. Got it? And the tasks you can see here that JSQL is trying each and every link possible and will find information for you. Right? So these all are the possibilities available inside SQL injection. Got it? So this is all about SQL injection, right? That is, the tool is called JSQL injection. It is available in Kali Linux. It is available inside database assessment tool. Try it, right? And this is the easiest way to perform SQL injection on websites or web servers. So thank you so much. And this is all about JSQL injection. And we will come back in the next video with more stuff. Thank you.